craft time. Today we're going to make a moon phase game. For this activity, you're going to need some light colored construction paper like pink or white or light blue or yellow, and some dark construction paper like black or dark blue or green. The next, also you need some tape, something to write with like a pen or colored pencils. And you're gonna need a little something that has a circle shape on the bottom. I'm using my water bottle, but you could use a bottle or a glass or a cup, and your scissors. Now, what this activity is a way to learn a little bit about the different shapes of the moon. And so what we're gonna do first is make those shapes of the moon. And we know that the moon is round like a ball, but we're going to cut out four circles to represent the moon shapes. And so in order to cut four circles, you can just trace around the moon. You can trace around the bottom of your flask four times. Or if you want to do four at once, you can fold your paper in half like this and then fold it in half again. And then you can trace it once and cut it and once, and that will make four circles all at once. So if I take my flask and I place it on here, trace around it one time. There I have the circle on there. And then if I cut that out, I did it before with blue, and I have my blue paper and four blue circles. There we go. Now these are going to be what we use to make the shapes of the moon. So one shape of the moon that we have is just the full moon, and that's the whole circle. So we're going to put that aside. That's one. And then another shape that you have is when the moon is just right, it's like cut in half. So we're going to take our scissors and you can draw a line and measure it, or you can just use your eyes and just cut it right in half. And now we have two halves that make a whole. There we go. So that's two more shapes. So we have one, two, three shapes of the moon. Another shape that you might recognize in the moon is a crescent shape. It's kind of like a smile or like a banana. So if we cut one of those out of the circle, we have the crescent shape. And we also have another shape, and this one is called gibbous. This is a gibbous moon. And we see this moon, the crescent moon and the gibbous moon, twice in the sky each month. So we're gonna cut another crescent shape and have a second crescent moon and a second gibbous moon. Great. Now we're gonna see how can we place those on a map or a little mat to play a game to understand more about what the moon phases are. So I'm gonna take our dark piece of paper and we're gonna make eight sections for the eight different shapes of the moon and then place them on the mat so that we can practice to understand more about where the moon goes. So to do that, we're going to fold it in eight sections. And again, we're going to take our piece of paper and we're gonna fold it once and then again and then one more time, and that's going to make this shape of a rectangle, and that will be eight sections. So I folded it up one time and then this way and then one more time, and when I open it up I have eight sections. Then so I can put a moon shape on each of those sections. You might want to draw a line on each of the sections, each of the places where you see a fold, to help you see those a little bit better. And I just took my water bottle and I placed it on to my mat, and then I traced around it eight times so that I have eight different shapes of the moon. And now we can help to remember what are the different shapes and where do they go, we're going to place them on there and then trace around the shape to make a little place where it goes. So we're going to start with the new moon, and a new moon means that there's no moon in the sky, so we're just going to leave that one blank. And then we're going to go to the next one where there's a very small little crescent shape, and that crescent shape is going to go into the mat on this side. So you can see that is a little crescent that's just starting to grow, and it goes like that. And then if you draw around it, then you can color in this side with a little bit of color to know that's where the moon, you don't see the moon, but you see this one shape. The next one is going to be the half moon shape that goes on this side, and we can trace around that. And then the gibbous moon. Oh, that's great, and it's growing bigger and bigger. And then as it grows bigger and bigger, it comes to the next shape, and we're going to go down here for that, and that's the full moon. So this is our beautiful full moon that's in the sky. And then once it's a full moon, it starts getting smaller again. And so we're going to go to that gibbous shape, but it's going to be on the other side this time. And so we grab a different gibbous shape, and it's going to go right here. We can do that and then trace around it so you know where it goes. And the next one is the half on this side, and then the crescent. And then once you trace around those and color it in, then you can take all of your shapes and put them to the side, and then practice placing them as a matching game to see where do they actually go on our mat that shows us about it. That's really fun. If you want to make it really a nice little thing, you can do a little pocket and put your moon shapes right into the pocket. And what I did is I just used the piece of paper that I cut the moon shapes out of, and I just cut off the top of that. And that has a little pocket you can see right there, and all my moon shapes can go right inside of that pocket there. And if I tape that on to my paper, then I have a nice handy place to put my moon shapes and have it all ready to go. I hope you enjoy this activity and play around with the shapes of the moon. They're so much fun to think about and also to look for in the sky every day and night to see where we can see the moon and what shape it is today. If you enjoy our craft activities and our story times, please give us a like and also subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can see our story times and craft times in your subscription box every time we upload one. Thanks so much for joining us today. Goodbye.